Hey guys, so this is the last time I will be addressing any of this on my channel. I decided to film this video for a number of reasons. One, there's a lot of misinformation out there. Two, I'm not going to be bullied into silence. And three, there's a lot of things I did not bring up in my first video because I didn't really think it was necessary, but I'm definitely going to touch on now. This is all surrounding a video I posted a week ago titled Dirty Dom Exposed My Story. It was my encounter slash experience with him at the VidCon after party where he pinned me down, reached down my shirt, and forced me to make out with him. I'm aware that since then, Dirty Dom has come out with an apology video. I watched it. It came across as pretty sincere until he got to the part where he said that he personally reached out to the girls involved and apologized for his behavior.
I personally reached out to the people I've disrespected in hopes that they'll accept my apology.
This is not true. I can assure you I received no apology from him. I'm very accessible on both Instagram and Twitter, as well as he has my phone number. And me watching that, if I didn't know any better, I would assume he was telling the truth. But just based off that, I don't buy his apology. I don't expect an apology from this dude, but I just wanted to point that out, that he completely lied about that part in his video. He also did not apologize to the 15-year-old girl. Her and I have been in contact. I'm going to put a screenshot up here. This is the girl that Elijah Daniel tweeted about, who reached out to him, and he anonymously posted a screenshot of her talking about how he filmed her ass dancing. And a lot of people were mistaking me for her in the video. I received a lot of comments about that. I am 20 years old and I was invited to that party. My name was on the guest list. But regardless of age and regardless of invitation, I still don't believe it's okay for a guy to touch a girl, or a girl to touch a guy, anyone to touch anybody without consent. Secondly, I just want to point out that I hadn't even thought about making a video telling my story and what happened until other people told me I should, because they were there and because I told them at the party, or they literally saw it. Also, contrary to what a lot of people were saying, I did not wait a year to post the video for attention. I actually posted it 4 days after the incident. This took place at VidCon 2017. Next, hundreds of you guys pointed out that his hair is pink, not blonde. You are correct. I shouldn't have said blonde in the video. That was my mistake, but he was in fact wearing a hat and it was dark, and it's pretty clear that his hair was blonde before it was pink. When I had blue streaks in my hair, I had to bleach it blonde first so the color would stay. So I just know that it must have been blonde underneath. He had light colored hair, okay? You get the point. Just because I said blonde instead of pink because it looked blonde to me when I saw him doesn't mean that I was lying about my story. That's one minor detail. Here I'm going to insert a clip of him dancing at the VidCon after party. I found this from a vlog, and you can see I'm near him as well. Also matching up with my story, this is before he led me out to the balcony, so I was completely comfortable dancing and being near him at this point, and you can see that right here. Also, when I was reading the comments, it dawned on me that a lot of people don't understand the definition of sexual assault, so I'm going to go ahead and read it for you guys. Sexual assault includes any kind of non-consensual sexual touching and or groping. So in that case, Dirty Dom most definitely sexually assaulted me when he reached down my shirt and grabbed my chest while pinning me down, and he wouldn't take no for an answer when I said I didn't want to kiss him. There was this random vlog I found after uploading my video titled Dirty Dom Caught Doing the Dirty. This guy, I wasn't subscribed to him. My friend actually found the vlog and sent it to me. And in the vlog, he says that he saw Dirty Dom on top of some girl making the F out with her. So I'll go ahead and insert that.
So we are at the Studio 71 party, and we literally came out here because my friend wanted to sit outside, and we saw Dirty Dom from David Dobrik's vlogs literally on top of a girl making the fuck out with her. Making the fuck out with her. Like, it was the funniest thing ever. All props to him.
He also says towards the end that he found it funny, that he was laughing, something along those lines. Going back to what I said in my video, the people who were watching didn't do anything about it. They almost found it entertaining, example A. And again, I just want to point out that from a distance, this could have looked consensual if they didn't see my face and that I was rejecting him kissing me. So I totally understand that. And I'm sure he just saw from across the balcony. This vlog clip, along with the other one that I showed earlier, also just kind of go to prove that he was in fact there at the VidCon after party, since a lot of people were trying to argue that he didn't go to that. Here's a picture that my friend Michelle Platy took. She's on YouTube. Many of you guys probably watch her and or have heard of her, and she can back up pretty much everything I'm saying because she was there. She took this when we first met Dirty Dom because he was whispering my ear and doing all that. He did not get super creepy until we got on the balcony and we were more in a secluded area. But there were many other people on the balcony. That's something that a lot of people were trying to say, that he took me to a dark room alone. There were multiple people who witnessed this happening. Now I'm gonna address some of the ignorant comments I received in that video. For one, a ton of people were saying that it's Dirty Dom. You should have known he was like that. That's just his sense of humor. That's just his brand. How was I supposed to know that was how he really was in real life? Especially considering I had never seen any of his videos. Believe it or not, I've only seen like 2 of David Dobrik's vlogs. It also baffles me that people can defend him based off his comedy style, or people even find disrespecting women entertaining. And I can assure you that if I had seen his vlogs prior to the incident, I probably would have stayed away from him, but unfortunately, I hadn't. People who were saying that I should have known not to go off with him because he already tried to kiss me. Yeah, he asked to kiss me. Yeah, he tried to kiss me, but he didn't aggressively force me to kiss him on the dance floor like he did over on the balcony. How on earth was I supposed to predict that he was gonna pin me down like that? The second comment that I keep getting is that my friends, it's their fault because they told me to talk to him. Again, one of my 2 friends I was with, Michelle and Olivia, one of them knew who he was and recognized him, but she had no idea he was like that in real life. How was anybody supposed to know that this was how that guy acted when he was off camera? So in no way was this either my friend's fault, and they're not bad friends for encouraging me to make other friends and go out and have a good time. It's literally a network party. That's kind of the point. You go off and you meet people and you make connections. Number 3, people are saying that I led him on. Even if this was the case, doesn't give him a right to do what he did, but regardless, people are saying this because I held his hand when he was leading me off the dance floor. We were not holding hands like a couple, okay? He grabbed my hand and led me off the dance floor so I wouldn't lose him because there was a bunch of people there. My friends and I were doing this as well, my girlfriends, when we went to get food so we wouldn't lose each other. You're just holding hands. There's a difference. We weren't like a couple walking around like I was his girlfriend. And even if that was the case, again, doesn't give him the right. Also, people are saying this because 2, I gave him my phone number. I gave a bunch of people my phone number there, both girls and boys, and a bunch of people gave me their phone number there, both girls and boys. This was a network party. These were all fellow YouTubers. These are like my colleagues, kind of, and I was meeting people, having fun, making friends. In no way does that give someone the right to sexually assault me because I gave them my phone number. Like, where is the logic in that? I honestly don't understand. People were also saying that it's my fault because of what I was wearing, because I was wearing a bodysuit, because I wasn't wearing a bra. You're not really supposed to wear bras with bodysuits, okay? And I could have been naked. Doesn't give someone the right to think that they're entitled to my body and doing what they want with it. Another comment I kept seeing was that he was drunk and so he didn't mean to do it and it's fine, he was just making a drunk mistake. So many people there were intoxicated, yet he was the only one who did what he did to me. Nobody else pinned me down and forced me to make out with them and reach down my shirt. And this is also not an excuse for that kind of behavior. And this doesn't allow people to treat girls or guys or anybody in that way. For those of you who are saying that I should have screamed so he would have got off of me, in retrospect, yeah, I probably should have. I did yell for him to get off of me and I did say no and other people heard me, but we're doing nothing about it. And I was really embarrassed already that he was on top of me and other people saw that because, like I said, I'm not one for PDA, whether it's consensual or not consensual, especially then. So I was really embarrassed and humiliated, but I did tell him to get off of me. He didn't listen. And also, this didn't go on for much longer until he did end up getting off of me because someone came over to talk to him. And then I got up and I left. But if it would have continued, I'm sure I would have screamed and took drastic measures to get him off of me if he didn't by that point. He had me pinned down, my arms right here. He had them locked like that with his hands, and then he was putting all of his weight on me with his knees on my knees, so I had no control. I couldn't get out of the situation. And last but not least, everyone who's saying I should have gone to the police versus making a story time video about it for views and attention, which is not why I made that video. I wanted to open the conversation of sexual assault because I think it's so important, and I wanted to stand up for the 15-year-old girl and anybody else who's had this kind of encounter with Dirty Dom because it just happened to me. And when I was in high school, I went through something a lot more severe than this, and I kept quiet about it for months, and when I finally did come forward, I told my mom, who then went to the police, and then everyone at school found out about it, and I was bullied, and even though the guy was found guilty, there was very little they could do about it because there was lack of evidence and things like that, even though he confessed and he admitted that he did everything I said he did. And that experience was completely traumatizing, and I had problems because of that for years. I went to therapy, I even attempted suicide and ended up in the hospital. This is a topic that is actually really, really important and means a lot to me, and I wish back then I would have spoke up and I would have fought more for it. And if you guys don't know me online, or if you guys are big supporters of Dirty Dom, I get it. I get that you're gonna want to defend him and you're gonna assume I'm lying and all this stuff, which is really sad that it has to be that way in society, but I have no reason to lie about any of this. And if you notice on my channel, I've never done an exposing video before, like I said, because I don't agree with that. I'm not one to make drama videos, but this was something that happened that I experienced, and I wanted to speak up about it. Thank you guys for watching. I hope this video helped to kind of back up everything I said last time or eliminate some of the confusion. If you guys are new, don't forget to subscribe, hit that thumbs up, or if you hate me, if you want to call me a liar some more, you can go ahead and dislike. That's fine too. And I will see you guys in the next video. Later, alligators. Bye.
All right, guys, so we're officially here at VidCon. I'm gonna try to do my little prostitution gig. We're gonna see how many girls I can sleep with for $500 before I get arrested.
Hey, who's got $500?
Try to find some girls to get that $500 hookup, that hotel meet and greet, if you know what I'm saying.
Yeah!
Hey, who's got 500? Who's got that 500? Who's got that 500? Exclusive Dirty Dom meet and greet, hotel room, $500.